Right, so we're here with the latest project of Vuorensaku and BDF in Mannheim with Reverb, and we're also showing the BDF 100, which is an app that I designed. But anyway, the reason to show this is that this is a guitar with a built-in vibe. It's a vibe guitar, and then one can ask, do you really need a vibe guitar? Let's say it could be an extension to what you're playing, and typically with this kind of let's say like this, modulations tend to dictate what you play, but this type of modulation is intended to support what you're playing and expand your musical ideas. So if we set the intensity low and have a very high speed, that would be a multiple to any speed. You can get when the speed is at the multiple of any rhythm, you can play any rhythm, and it will support you anyway. So, and then there are two settings that we typically use on intensity. One where you got now, in addition attention to the circuit being a vibe, it is also a boost. So we have a volume control. Tremendously loud. What if you could crank an amp, but then also control the volume without to set it at any desirable level? So here we got the beard control. Typically, you would have a clean sound that would sound something like this. Something like once every decade. The rest of the time, the sound man says, can you lower that thing? So, it would be nice. I would love to be able to set a great sound and just, okay, I can set this at the sound level that keeps the sound man happy. And if he says, can you turn up the guitar? I can do that. That would make me so happy. So, that's, as I said, that would be a clean sound, but okay, we have... We also have in this channel, we can increase the what I mean by that, usually people would say that I don't want a clean sound, I want a sound with a bit of hair. Can I get it a bit hairier? And then I'm thinking, hair in what sense? Well, maybe facial hair. So that's the kind of joke with getting a hairier sound. Well, this one has a beard control, so you can get a hairier sound. That's easy. And not to offend bald people. So, obviously it has a distorted channel too, because everybody needs that. You just do. It's the first question a guitarist asks. Whenever he sees an amplifier, can I get the distortion? It's the first question easily. So, curious. And even have Bluetooth and no cables and whatever. But you need to make it as acceptable to the customer.
Just 1 minute left.
Okay. What do you want to know? Right. 1 minute left.
Where do you can find us, like German circle? Tell us about that.
Okay. It is like this. Why make a guitar with a built-in effect? Obviously, this has been done since the 50s and it has failed because people got tired of the batteries and whatever, and the things got heavy in it, and they had special cables. But again, it's about this. If you can get the user interface so that it is intuitive to a musician, and you can get an effect that seems to belong to the instrument and expand the instrument. And I was a bit questioning this a bit, if a vibe in the guitar would do that. But after having played it for a while, I realized that it is super cool to be able to... Just by adjusting the controls, I can save playing another chord. I can just stay on that minor chord, and it becomes, it's a good chord, but it becomes more interesting because I changed the texture of it. And of course, voicing a little.